Welcome back to my channel. My name is Ultra. This is Feed the Mind TV. So today we are going to talk about the 7 steps in making moral decisions. But before we are going to proceed to our topic for today, we are going to have a short review from the previous video that we just discussed about morality. So when we say morality, it is knowing what is right, not just for you, but for others as well. Our reason should recognize what is good for us and for the people that might be affected by our actions. So it means that when we do some action, we have to think about the other person. We have to think about what might be the effect of our action towards the person or towards the people around us. So that's being able to decide what actions yung kailangan natin gawin na kailangan good not just for ourselves but for other people as well. So going forward, one way of ensuring the rationality and impartiality of moral decisions is to follow the 7-step moral reasoning model. So what are the 7 steps that will serve as our guide in making the right choices of doing a moral action? But before that, if this is the first time that you visit my channel, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to get updates coming from this channel. So the first one, stop and think. So when we say stop and think, before you make any decisions in your life, it is best to take a moment to think about the situation itself. You have to analyze the situation. You have to think about your place in it and other surrounding factors which merit consideration, such as the people involved and the potential effects of your decisions on them. This involves a step back from the situation to make sure that you do not act out of impulse. So you have to make sure na hindi ka basta-basta na lang gumawa ng isang action based on your feelings. You have to stop and think. You have to analyze first the situation. Take a moment to think about the whole situation. So ganun dapat, you have to stop and think. Kung nasa situation ka wherein nabigla ka sa isang situation, you have to take control of your emotion. Kailangan you have an idea what might be the consequence kung ano man yung action na gagawin mo. So that's for number 1. Number 2, clarify goals. It is also necessary to clarify your short-term and long-term aims. One often decides on the basis of what he or she wants to accomplish. Sometimes, in the heat of the moment, short-term wants eclipse long-term goals. Thus, you must determine if you are willing to sacrifice more important life goals to achieve your short-term goals. If you, for example, are seeking retribution for harm caused by another person, you have to think about the long-term consequence of revenge on your character in the long run. So you have to make sure that you realize ano ba yung dapat mong gawin? Ano ba yung short-term goal mo? Ano ba yung long-term goal mo? Then, if you are trying to decide na kung paano maabot yung pangarap mo in a long-term goal, you have to make sure na alam yung magiging consequence. Are you going to prioritize yung short-term goal mo or mas mahalaga sa yung long-term goal mo? So it's up to you. You're the only person who can answer that question. So ask yourself, ano ba yung gusto ko? So by knowing your goals, you have that objective na magpo-focus ka dun for you to be able to achieve kung ano yung gusto mo sa buhay. So that's number 2. Number 3, determine facts. So make sure you gather enough information before you make a choice. An intelligent choice is one that is supported by verified facts. You must first make sure that what you know is enough to merit action. Without verifying facts, you may regret your choice in the future once various aspects of situation come to light. Never make a choice on the basis of hearsay. Make sure your sources are credible and have integrity. So when we say determined facts, you have to make sure na valid yung reason, valid yung sources na nakuha mo. Hindi pwede na naniwala ka lang dun sa mga sabi-sabi, sa mga hearsay, sa mga chismes. You have to make sure that you will be able to validate all the facts, all the information in terms of the situation kung saan andun ka. That way, whatever the action na gusto mong gawin in the future or after you analyze the problem, is tama yung magiging action mo. Kasi you were able to determine yung mga facts. You were able to validate na tama yung mga nadinig mo. Na tama yung information na nakuha mo. And that's for number 3. Determine facts. Number 4, develop options. So once you are clear in terms of your goals and facts, try to come up with alternative options to exhaust all possible courses of action. Most of the time, the pressure of a situation may make you feel you have less options than you think. Clear your mind. That's very important. We have to clear our mind and we have to try to think of other creative ways of clarifying motives and implementing your actions with the least ethical compromise. So the good thing about having a lot of options, you have a lot of choices. You have a lot of actions na pwede mong gawin. May plan A ka, may plan B ka. Just in case this happened, you know what might be yung action na pwede mong gawin. Kung sakaling sumabla yung gagawin mo, you have another choices that you will be able to maximize. That way, hindi ka mawawala ng option. So kung may plan A ka, you have to have option number 2. So that's for number 4, develop options. Number 5, consider consequences. So filter your choices and separate the ethical from the unethical choices, bearing in mind both your motives and the potential consequences of your action. Think of long-term consequences and act in accordance with the principles of justice and fairness. Consequences are historical realities that bear upon the lives of others. A decision turns something in your mind into reality. Make sure you do not regret the decision you have conferred reality upon. So by considering your consequence, you will be able to think one step ahead of the game. You will be able to think what might be the result of that specific action na ginawa mo. Kasi andun na yung isip mo na alam mo na yung magiging result. Alam mo na yung magiging consequence. Just in case ito yung gagawin ko, ano yung posibleng result? Ano yung posibleng outcome from the action that I just did? So by having that advanced critical thinking, now consider mo na yung posibleng mangyari. And you are one step ahead of the game. So that's considering the outcome. Considering the consequence of what might be your action na gusto mong gawin. Number 6, choose. You have to make a decision. If the choice is hard for you to make, you have to try consulting other people who may have the knowledge or experience of your situation. You have to find people with a virtuous character and you have to compare your reasoning with your moral analysis. So once you make up your mind, summon the will to do the right thing even if it is hard and seemingly counterintuitive. So you have to make sure that you have to decide. Kahit na minsan, it's really hard for us to decide on a certain situation. You have to make a decision. But it's easy for us to decide kung alam natin yung tama at mali. And sometimes, kahit na hindi natin gusto yung isang bagay, but if we are sure in that that's the right thing to do, we should have the will to do the right thing. And that's making a choice. You have to choose to do the right thing. So that's number 6. Number 7, monitor and modify. Monitor what happens after your decision and have enough humility to modify your action or behavior as necessary. Pride may get in the way of admitting that you might have not thought out a decision well enough. As you become more aware of whatever the consequences of your actions, especially on the lives of others, summon the strength and determination to make changes to rectify any shortcomings. Do not hesitate to revise your decisions in light of new developments in the situations. So in number 7, for monitoring and modifying a certain situation, you should know when and how you will be able to revise, to do something. Just in case na hindi siya nag-succeed dun sa gusto mong mangyari, you have to make sure that you have to do something about it. So you're not just only monitoring your situation, but just in case na hindi siya mag-work out, you have another options. You have another plan how you will be able to modify yung action na ginawa mo. So when we say modifying a certain situation, you will be able to make things right instead of hahayaan mo lang yung situation na ganun. Nagkamali ka or hindi siya naging successful, hayaan mo na siya. No, it's not like that. Kung alam mong hindi siya nag-succeed, then you learn from it and you are to modify it next time around. That way, maiko-correct mo yung ginawa mong mali. So yung modifying dito is, it is if and only if na hindi siya mag-work out. Hindi siya magiging tama yung outcome ng ginawa mo. But if everything's went right, then you're just going to monitor it. No need for you to modify. So you only going to modify a certain situation, a certain action, if and only if nagkamali ka or hindi naging successful yung action na ginawa mo. So that's the difference between doing a monitoring or modification sa isang action. So all these 7 steps or guidelines in making a moral decision, it is very important for us as a person, for us as a human being, to be able to make a very good decision in terms of doing some action. This will help us to be a better person, not just today, but also in the future. And I hope that you learned something from this video. And again, if this is the first time that you visit my channel, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to get updates coming from this channel. And you can check other videos about ethics, about purposive communication, as well as tutorial videos about motivation, and this will really help you in terms of being a very good person and to do what is right for everybody. Again, my name is Ultra. This is Feed the Mind TV.